वेलकम टू सेकंड ईयर बीएससी फोर्थ सेमिस्टर स्टैटिस्टिक्स स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज केवीआर नरसिंहराव, लेक्चरर इन स्टैटिस्टिक्स, श्री वेंकटेश्वर कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट्स एंड साइंस, मलापुरम, ईस्ट गोदावरी डिस्ट्रिक्ट, एफिलिएटेड टू आदिकवि नन्ना यूनिवर्सिटी, राजमंड्री. टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन लेसन नंबर टू ऑफ यूनिट टू नेम्ड statistical hypothesis of your fourth semester statistics paper inference theory. The first unit is estimation theory. I have completed the estimation theory of nearly 13 lessons of width not less than 40 minutes of each class, and I have also completed one lesson on the concept of statistical hypothesis. What is meant by statistical hypothesis? Once we have to review what we have learned earlier, that is in lesson number one of this unit, that is first one is statistical hypothesis. Any statistical statement or any statistical assertion regarding the parameters of the population is called statistical hypothesis. Statistical hypotheses are mainly two types. One is simple statistical hypothesis. Second one is composite statistical hypothesis. Simple statistical hypothesis is a statistical hypothesis which completely specifies each and every parameter of the population. Whereas composite statistical hypothesis is a statistical hypothesis which can leave at least one parameter unspecified of a population is called composite statistical hypothesis. That means a statistical hypothesis which completely specifies each and every parameter, then the statistical hypothesis is called simple statistical hypothesis. Whereas the statistical hypothesis which can leave at least one parameter left unspecified, that is called composite statistical hypothesis. Next one is the simple and statistical composite statistical hypothesis are mainly of two types. One is null hypothesis, second one is alternative hypothesis. Null hypothesis is the statistical hypothesis of no difference or zero difference or nil difference is called null hypothesis. Null hypothesis is a statistical hypothesis of zero difference between the comparative items, or what we have to be tested, we have assumed that there is no significant difference between the comparative items, or it is taken from a particular population or not, then the positive aspect of statement is called null hypothesis. It is generally denoted by H0. That is, null hypothesis is a hypothesis of no difference or zero difference. It is denoted by H0. For testing, the sample is taken from a population, null hypothesis H0 is S, the sample is taken from the specified population. And if there is any significant difference between two population means mu1 mu2, then H0, there is no significant difference between mu1 mu2, that is H0 mu1 is equal to mu2, like that. Whether the observations are independent or not, H0, the observations are independent. These are the examples of null hypothesis. Second one is alternative hypothesis. Any statistical hypothesis which is entirely against to null hypothesis is called alternative hypothesis. It is generally denoted by H1. Alternative hypothesis is generally denoted by H1. It is a statistical hypothesis which is against to null hypothesis is called alternative hypothesis.
For example, whether the sample is taken from a population or not, null hypothesis H0, the sample is taken from the specified population. H1, two types, three options are there. One, the sample is not taken from the specified population. Another is the sample has taken from another population. These are the two options for alternative hypothesis. So, in another example, for testing whether mu1 is equal to mu2, H0, mu1 is equal to mu2. H1 having three options, mu1 not equal to mu2, mu1 greater than mu2, mu1 less than mu2. The first alternative is called, indicates the test is two-tailed test. Second and third options indicates the test is one-tailed test. Hence, alternative hypothesis specifies the test is one-tailed or two-tailed. That is, if it is one-tailed, less than indicates left-tailed test, greater than indicates right-tailed. For every distribution, the graphs having two tails, that is, left-tail and right-tail. If both tails are taken into consideration, then the test is called two-tailed test. If only one of the tails is taken into consideration, that is one-tailed test. Only left tail is into consideration, then the test is called left-tail test. Only right tail is taken into consideration for testing, that is called right-tail test. This is the alternative hypothesis. But what is the use of null hypothesis? Null hypothesis is used to compute the test statistic. Compute the test statistic. And that means the test statistic can be computed under H0. What the conditions in H0 are given are the basis for computing the test statistic. Next one is critical region. Critical region or rejection region. The region in which the sample point falls, or reject the null hypothesis, is called critical region or rejection region. The region in which the sample point falls, we accept the null hypothesis, is called acceptance region. In the whole sample space, generally, two types of regions are there. The region, in certain region, the sample point falls, we say that the null hypothesis is to be accepted. In some region it falls, it is definitely the null hypothesis to be rejected. In certain region, the sample point falls, we definitely accept the null hypothesis. So therefore, in which region the sample point falls, we reject the null hypothesis, is called critical region or rejection region. It is generally denoted by small omega or W. So, that means X belongs to omega, we reject H0, then W is called critical region or rejection region. If X belongs to W bar, then we accept H0, then W bar is called exception region, such that W union W bar is equal to omega, the whole sample space. That means the whole sample, for example, in declaring the results of certain examination, the authorities have decided the candidates who got more than 40 marks will be considered as pass. That means the region from below 40 is called critical region. The region above and are equal to 40 is called acceptance region. That is the distinction between critical region, acceptance region. That is, let x1, x2, etc., xi, etc., xn be a sample of size n taken from a population. W and W are two regions. If xi belongs to W, we reject H0 for all I equal to 1 to n. Then W is called a critical region. If xi belongs to W bar, we accept H0, then W bar is called acceptance region. Next one is types of errors. In Next one is testing of hypothesis. We have already learned statistical hypothesis, simple hypothesis, null hypothesis, alternative hypothesis, composite hypothesis, critical reason. These are the topics we have already learned. Now, what is meant by testing of hypothesis? Testing of hypothesis is a two-action decision problem, TWO2. Two-action decision problem. In purchasing an item, there are only two alternatives. Whether it is to be purchased or not to be purchased. Like that. Testing of hypothesis is a two-action decision problem. Whether to accept the null hypothesis or reject the null hypothesis is called testing of hypothesis. Testing of hypothesis is a two-action, TWO2, action decision problem. Whether to accept or reject the null hypothesis is called testing of statistical hypothesis. Next one is types of errors in testing of hypothesis. In testing of hypothesis, we are generally observing two types of errors are generally committed. The two types of errors are, before going to the error, first we have to know when we accept, when we reject. If we are asking a question to a student, if the student correctly answering the question, then the teacher has only one option, that is to accept his answer. If the student attempting not correctly, that is wrong way, then the teacher has only one alternative, that is to reject the answer. These are the general phenomena occurring in our real life. But in testing of hypothesis, if the student attempting the question in a right way, even the teacher may reject the answer. Then that is called type 1 error. Rejecting H0, rejecting the null hypothesis, when the null hypothesis is true, even the teacher knows the student what has he attempted the question is right, even though due to certain reason, the teacher may reject the answer, that is called type 1 error. That means type 1 error means rejecting the null hypothesis H0, when the H0 is true, is called type 1 error. That is, if X belongs to omega, that is X belongs to W, we reject the null hypothesis. That means even the H0 is true, even though we reject H0. That means XI belongs to omega under H0 true is called type 1 error. Generally, there are two types of awarding the marks by a teacher. One is awarding correct marks to the correct answer. Another is awarding correct marks for the incorrect answer. So these are the two committed errors. The first type of error is, even the answer is right, the teacher may reject, that is called type 1 error. Another is, even the answer is wrong, the teacher accept it is true, it is right, that is another type of error. Type 1 error is rejecting H0 when H0 true. Type 2 error is accepting H0 when H0 false. These are the two types of errors are generally observing in testing of hypothesis. So, rejecting H0, H0 true is same as accepting H1, H1 false. Another is accepting H0, H0 false, rejecting H1, H1 true. These are the type 1 error and type 2 error respectively. Now, these cannot guarantee to occur in any testing of hypothesis.
they may be, these two types of errors may committed in the testing of hypothesis. So there may have certain chances. The probability of the occurrence of type 1 error is called level of significance. That means probability of x belongs to omega under H0 true is called level of significance alpha. If x is discrete, then alpha is equal to sigma likelihood function under H0 in omega. That is called alpha. Whereas in x is discrete, alpha is equal to integral L0 dx under omega. These are the alpha value, that is level of significance. Level of significance is the permissible error in testing. How much extent you have to accept in the error, that is denoted by alpha. In testing of hypothesis, 100% correct may not be possible. In those cases, we may accept certain amount of error. That amount of error is accepted in testing can be decided by alpha. That is alpha, level of significance. Sometimes it may be called as size of the test also. So what is the formula for alpha? Alpha is equal to probability of x belongs to w under H0 is equal to sigma L0 under omega for discrete. Integral L0 dx under omega. This is the value of alpha. Next, the probability of committing of type 2 error is called beta. Probability of committing type 2 error. Probability of possibility of second type of error. That means, what is the probability of accepting H0 when H0 falls? That means, x belongs to W bar even though H0 is to be accepted. That is called probability of type 2 error or beta. This probability of type 2 error beta, that is beta is equal to P of xi belongs to W bar. Probability of xi belongs to W bar. For discrete, it is equal to sigma L1 under W bar. For continuous, it is integral L1 dx W bar. Then 1 minus beta is called power of the test. 1 minus beta. So if you know beta, then 1 minus beta is equal to integral L1 dx W. For continuous case, sigma L1 in for discrete case. This is the power of the test. It is generally denoted by 1 minus beta. Next one is best critical region. What is meant by best critical region? BCR. Among the critical region, which critical region has more power than any other critical region? Then that critical region is called best critical region. That is, if W be one critical region having power 1 minus beta, choose any other critical region W1 having power 1 minus beta 1. If 1 minus beta greater than or equal to 1 minus beta 1, then W is called BCR. That is best critical region. Next one is unbiased critical region. What is meant by unbiased critical region? If W be a critical region having level of significance alpha, power 1 minus beta, and 1 minus beta greater than or equal to alpha, then W is called unbiased critical region. The critical region whose power is more than level of significance, then that critical region is called unbiased critical region. What is best test? The test based on best critical region is called best test, and the test based on unbiased critical region is called unbiased test. Now we go to what is meant by the most powerful critical region and most powerful test. Suppose in testing a parameter theta, the null hypothesis H0 theta is equal to theta naught against null alternative hypothesis H1 theta is equal to theta 1. Let W and W1 be two critical regions having levels of significance, level of significances alpha and alpha 1, and alpha less than or equal to alpha 1. Alpha 1 less than or equal to alpha, and power of first critical region W is 1 minus beta, power of the second critical region W1 is 1 minus beta 1, and 1 minus beta greater than or equal to 1 minus beta 1, then W is called most powerful critical region, that is MPCR, and the test based on MPCR is called MPC test, that is most powerful test, MP test. Next one is, what is meant by unbiased critical, what is meant by uniformly most powerful test and uniformly most powerful critical region? Uniformly most powerful critical region and uniformly most powerful test. For testing theta, H0, theta is equal to theta naught against H1, theta not equal to theta naught. Whereas in MPCR, theta is equal to theta 1 for null alternate hypothesis. Whereas in the uniformly most powerful test critical region, H1 has not been specified. That is a right tail test. Whereas in MPCR, alternate hypothesis is only test. It is neither one tail or two tail. Whereas in the uniformly most powerful critical region, the test is definitely a two-tailed test. And W and W1B, two critical regions having level of significances alpha and alpha 1, such that alpha 1 less than or equal to alpha, and power of W is 1 minus beta, power of W1 is 1 minus beta 1, and 1 minus beta greater than or equal to 1 minus beta 1, then W is uniformly most powerful critical region, UMPCR. And the test based on UMPCR is called UMP test. These are the topics which have been discussed in the lesson number 1. So, I have reviewed what the topics that we have discussed in lesson number 1. Today, I will explain problems on determining best critical region, level computation of alpha, beta, 1 minus beta, and which critical region has more power can be computed, and deciding which is best critical region also in lesson number 2. Today I will start lesson number 2 of unit 2, testing of hypothesis of your 4th semester statistics paper, inference theory. So these are the topics which have been discussed, that is statistical hypothesis, simple statistical hypothesis, composite statistical hypothesis, null hypothesis, alternative hypothesis, critical region, acceptance region, testing of hypothesis, types of errors, level of significance, power of the test, one tail and two tail tests. And next one is uniformly most powerful test, uniformly most powerful critical region, most powerful critical region, most powerful test, unbiased critical region, unbiased test. Now we go to in explaining problems of determining alpha, beta, 1 minus beta. The first problem is, given the frequency function एफ एक्स टीटा इज ईक्वल टू वन बाई टीटा जीरो लेस दैन आर ईक्वल टू एक्स लेस दैन आर ईक्वल टू टीटा इज ईक्वल टू जीरो अदरवाइज एंड टेस्टिंग द नल हाइपोथेसिस एच जीरो टीटा इज ईक्वल टू वन अगेनेस्ट एच वन टीटा इज ईक्वल टू टू बाय मीन्स ऑफ सिंगल ऑब्जर्व्ड वैल्यू एक्स एज सैंपल फाइंड द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ टाइप वन एरर एंड टाइप टू एरर्स इफ द क्रिटिकल रीजियन इफ द इंटरवल फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन एक्स ग्रेटर दैन आर ईक्वल टू जीरो पॉइंट फर्स्ट क्रिटिकल रीजियन एक्स ग्रेटर दैन आर ईक्वल टू जीरो पॉइंट फाइव सेकेंड वन लेस दैन आर ईक्वल टू एक्स लेस दैन आर ईक्वल टू वन पॉइंट फाइव as critical regions also obtain the power of the tests also. So given the function is fx theta is equal to 1 by theta 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to theta is equal to 0 otherwise ante ikkada endi fx theta anetuvandidi x value 0 ki theta ki madhyalo unnapudu 1 by theta migilina ye sandarbhamlo sare functional value 0. In this case, what the parameter theta? For testing parameter theta, null hypothesis H0, theta is equal to 1. H1, theta is equal to 2. What is formula for alpha? Alpha is equal to, this is a continuous case. So what is alpha formula? Integral L0 dx. What is L0? Likelihood function under H0. How a likelihood function can be obtained? By taking sample. In the above hypothesis, only one observation is taken as sample. That means likelihood function L is equal to, actual original formula is pi I is equal to 1 to any f of x I comma theta. But only one observation is taken, then L is equal to f. L is equal to f x theta only. That is L is equal to f x theta is equal to 1 by theta, 0 less than x. Less than or equal to theta. L0, that is L under H0 theta is equal to 1. That is 1 by 1 is equal to 1. That is L1, L0. What is L1? L1 is equal to L under H1. What is H1? Theta is equal to 2. So L1 is equal to 1 by 2. L1 is equal to 1 by 2. L0 is equal to 1. First question. Choose the critical region W is equal to x greater than or equal to 0.5. That is W bar is equal to x less than 0.5. Critical region is x greater than or equal to 0.5. That means accepted region is x less than 0.5. What is the power of level of significance alpha? Alpha is equal to integral L0 dx under W. Under W means x limits from up to 0.5 to infinity. 0.5 to infinity. Therefore, integral 0.5 to infinity. What is the theta value? Maximum limits? 1 because of H0, theta is equal to 1. So, it means 0.5 to 1 are the limits. Therefore, alpha is equal to integral 0.5 to 1 L0 dx is equal to 0.5 to 1 1 dx is equal to 1 minus 0.5 is equal to 0.5. Level of significance alpha is equal to 0.5, that is 50%. Next. Beta is equal to integral L1 dx W. L1 dx W bar, sorry. L1 dx W bar. Or 1 minus beta is. L1 dx W is 1 minus beta, that is 1 minus beta is equal to integral
zero point five to two one by two dx is equal to 0.75. 1 minus beta is equal to 1 minus 0.75. Because 0.5 to 2, 1 by 2 dx, 1 by 2 into x. 2 minus 0.5 is 1.5. 1.5 is 0.75. Beta is equal to 0.25. Therefore, 1 minus beta is equal to 0.75. That is the first problem. Second problem is critical region W is equal to 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1.5. Alpha is equal to integral L0 dx W. That is 1 to 1.5 1 dx. Is equal to 1.5 minus 1, 0.5. So this critical region having also alpha 0.5. Next, power of the test. 1 minus beta is equal to integral L1 dx 1 to 1.5. That's value is 0.25. Therefore, beta is equal to 0.75. Next, another problem. Let P be the probability that A win A will win head appears in a single toss in order to test H0P is equal to 1 by 2 against P is equal to 3 by 4. The coin is tossed 5 times and H0 is rejected if x greater than or equal to 4. Then find alpha, beta, 1 minus beta, 1 minus alpha. Given the hypothesis H0 theta is equal to 1 by 2, P is equal to 1 by 2 against H1 P is equal to 3 by 4. What is the functional value? Px. P of capital P of x comma P comma n. N is given as 5. Is equal to 5cx p power x 1 minus p power 5 minus x. That is px. Now single observation is taken as sample. Then the likelihood function L is equal to 5cx p power x 1 minus p power 5 minus x. L0 is equal to p of x is equal to 5, p of x equal to x, that is 5, under p is equal to 1 by 2, that is 5cx 1 by 2 power x into 1 minus 1 by 2 power 5 minus x is equal to 5cx into 1 by 2 whole power 5. L1 is equal to p L1 under H1, that is 5cx 3 by 4 power x into 1 by 4 power 5 minus x. These are the L0 and L1. Alpha is equal to level of significance. Alpha is equal to integral sigma, because of discrete case. This is for binomial distribution. Sigma under W P of x. The critical region x greater than or equal to 4. Under W L0. That is equal to sigma x is equal to 4 to 5 p of x is equal to x. That is 5c4 into 1 by 2 power 4 into 1 minus 1 by 2 power 5 minus 4 plus 5c5 into 1 by 2 power 5 into 1 minus 1 by 2 power 5 minus 5. On simplification,
alpha is equal to 0.187. That is alpha. What is 1 minus alpha? 0.913. 0.913 is 1 minus alpha. Next, power of the test. 1 minus beta is equal to sigma L1 under W. L1 is equal to 5C X 3 by 4 power X into 1 by 4 power 5 minus X. X is equal to 4 to 5. That is, X is equal to sigma X is equal to 4 comma 5. 5C X 3 by 4 power X into 1 by 4 power X. On substituting the values, 1 minus beta is equal to 0.632 and beta is equal to 0.368. Okay, we go to next another problem. If X greater than or equal to 1 is the critical region for testing H0, theta is equal to 2 against H1, theta is equal to 1 on the basis of single observation, the population fx theta is equal to theta into e power minus theta x, 0 less than or equal to 0 less than x less than infinity, and obtain alpha 1 minus alpha beta 1 minus beta. Fx theta is equal to theta into e power minus theta x, 0 less than or equal to x less than infinity. H0 theta is equal to 2, H1 theta is equal to 1. Like Hilbert function L is same as fx theta because single observation is taken. L is equal to theta into e power minus theta x. L0 is equal to L under H0. That is, L0 is equal to 2 into e power minus 2x. 2 into e power minus 2x. Therefore, alpha is equal to integral 1 to infinity 2 into e power minus 2x dx. So, integration just in value. One. Alpha is equal to 1. Next, beta. 1 minus beta, power. 1 minus beta is equal to integral L1 dx W. Not integral 0 to infinity, integral 1 to infinity, not. That's why there is a mistake in wrong. Once you remember, in the problem, the limits are taken as 0 to infinity. Limits 0 to infinity tiskunnaro, toppadi. Adi endante 1 to infinity tiskovali. Aa tappu cheyatam valla problem wrong vachindi. Avi 1 to infinity avi. 1 to infinity aithe is equal to 1 by e avutadi. 1 by e. Alpha is 1 by e. 1 minus alpha is equal to e minus 1 by e. Next, power of the test. 1 minus beta is equal to integral L1 dx under W. That is equal to, what is L1? Theta is equal to 1. That is 1 into e power minus 1x. That is e power minus x. Therefore, 1 minus beta is equal to integral 1 to infinity e power minus x dx is equal to e power minus x by minus 1, 1 to infinity is equal to e power minus infinity plus e power minus 1. Is equal to 1 by e also. This is also 1 by e. So hence, my dear students, I have completed the problems in finding alpha level of significance from a power of the test and 1 minus alpha and 1 minus beta also. So I will explain next one more important, very important, definitely asking, because this chapter having only one theorem and only one essay question like this, and this is the Neyman-Pearson's fundamental lemma. It is J. Neyman and E. S. Pearson, not Carl Pearson. So fundamental theorem on testing of hypothesis, or Neyman's fundamental theorem on simple null hypothesis against simple alternative hypothesis will be discussed in the next class. That is in lesson number 3, I will explain Neyman-Pearson's fundamental lemma. Okay? Thank you.